the Feasts of the Lord, or Divine Appointments. These are ancient prophetic dates or rehearsals that have been passed down through generations, and the feast dates overlay perfectly on the biblical prophetic timeline. The scriptures present seven feasts in total. The first four occur in the spring and foretold the first coming of the Messiah. For example, the first spring feast, known as Passover, prophesied the very day that the Messiah would be sacrificed.
These feasts begin with Passover, but something very special happened on Passover. That was the day that Jesus was crucified.
He fulfilled these feasts to the exact day. For example, for Passover, they would take a blameless, spotless lamb and they would use that to sacrifice for their sins. And so all the symbolism wrapped up in the Passover sacrifice, Jesus fulfilled, even coming and presenting himself as the Lamb of God. John the Baptist, when he saw Jesus, said, "Behold, the Lamb of God." He wasn't just speaking figuratively.
There are four in the spring, and there are three that are in the fall. And what you find is a pattern here, that the first four in the spring were all fulfilled in the first coming of the Messiah, Jesus Christ. But we are now on the verge of the beginning and the fulfillment of the final three feasts.
And this is where things become interesting. The remaining feasts, all taking place in the fall, appear to foretell the second coming of the Messiah during the last generation. And new ancient cultural discoveries surrounding the next feast to be fulfilled have been shaking the theological community.
The next feast to be fulfilled is called the Feast of Trumpets, or Rosh Hashanah.
What I find so amazing about the Feast of Trumpets is it's the day that nobody knows the day or the hour. They would count from the last new moon until the new moon. But the new moon is this tiny little sliver in the sky, and you can only see it from about, say, 6 to maybe 10 o'clock at night. If you're not looking for it, you're going to miss it. If it's cloudy, you're not going to see it. There's all kinds of reasons that you would not see the new moon. So unless you can visually see it, you could not declare the new moon. But when two people saw it, two witnesses, they would then go to the leadership, and once they decided, yep, we really do have the new moon, then they would declare that the Feast of Trumpets would begin.
So when Jesus was answering the question, "When are you returning?" his answer was, "Nobody knows the day or the hour." He was literally saying, "I am returning on the feast that you have been celebrating for 1,500 years that you yourselves call, nobody knows the day or the hour." So I agree, we can't know the exact day or the hour, but that phrase has been taken way out of context.
So if this is indeed what Jesus meant, then are we destined to repeat the mistakes of our past, like those that were caught unaware during the first coming of Christ around 2,000 years ago? Will the last generation today also be blind to the signs and warnings that surround us?
Jesus rebuked the Pharisees very sternly for not knowing the time of his visitation. So they should have known that. He says, "Look, you guys can read this, the sky to see if it's going to rain tomorrow, but you don't know the time of my visitation." That's why I think it's important that we do take the prophecies very seriously.